Good morning. So today I am going to be sharing with you some things that you can do to make your home look professionally staged without having to pay all that money to make it look good. But first, I'm going to need some coffee. Okay, now I can think straight. So, real life, some days I make my bed, some days I don't. I also have kids who usually don't make their bed, and I'm always stepping on Legos, tripping over toys, and when it's grocery day and I come home, sometimes I can't even get the groceries in the cabinet before the kids need something else. That's real life. But when you're listing your home, you have to make it a little bit different so buyers can come in and imagine themselves living there. So I have listed and sold my own home, and through helping buyers looking through homes and helping sellers sell their homes, I have learned what to do and what not to do when selling. Do you want some tips to help you? Let's get to it. You don't have to spend a lot of money for your house to look good. Let's start in the bathrooms. So with the bathrooms, you know, use a bath mat and towels that aren't going to be used a lot. So go to the store, buy a couple brand new ones, and when you have a showing, bring them out. And then when you're living your daily life, put them away in the closet, fold them up, just stuff that won't have footprints on them and they're not wet. Make sure that you clear off the countertops, maybe just leave a little hand soap or decorative items, a jar of Q-tips or cotton balls, a hand towel, but hairbrushes and toothbrushes and toothpaste. Make sure all of that stuff is tucked away in the drawers or cabinets, somewhere else. Okay, I don't know about you, but I have kids and toys are just everywhere. So with toys, you don't have to get rid of them all. With the toys, just tuck them away, get them away, get a little storage thing for them. I mean, I have five kids, so we have a lot of toys, but they can be tucked away. So check this out. Maybe like these cubes and cubby holes, just tuck them away, make sure they're not on the floor. It's a tripping hazard to all those visitors checking out your home. Okay, so a spot that is very important to a lot of buyers is the kitchen. So with the kitchen, it's okay to leave out, you know, your coffee maker, some utensils, but you wanna make sure that it's not too cluttered. So maybe some decorative cutting boards is okay, a bowl of lemons, but all those groceries and boxes and things, make sure that those are put away in the pantry or the cupboards, tucked away somewhere, and make it look nice and crisp and clean. Clean off those countertops and, you know, with some cleaner. And another one too that people often forget is the appliances. So if your appliances are the type to get those sticky fingerprints on them, like in my house, I do have the stainless steel, make sure you're doing a quick wipe down of those so that there's no fingerprints visible when folks are walking through your home. I don't know what cup I'm on, but it's so good. It looks like it's gonna be warm today, and now I wanna switch gears to iced coffee instead of hot coffee. Anyone else? Let's talk a little bit about the bedroom. So the bedroom is somewhere where we like live heavy, right? Because we're sleeping there and the bed gets messed up and we're just throwing clothes around. I don't know about you, but like that's just how life gets, right? So make sure with the bedroom that you make your bed, get everything tidied up. So if you have clothes on the floor, dirty laundry on the floor, throw them into your laundry basket, stick them in the washer for the showing. just anything under the bed, make sure it's like tidy and underneath. Like I use under my bed for storage because five kids, like my house feels like it's shrinking on me sometimes. So I do have some like luggage under my bed. And then some photo frames that I'm not using are under my bed. And so just make sure those are tucked away so you can't see them when you're walking by. And I'm trying to think of what else. So I have like some decorative pillows. Sometimes I just toss them on the floor, and a decorative blanket. Throw it back on the bed, make sure the bed's made. And then nightstands. If you have nightstands in your bedroom, like me, I have water and I wake up at night so thirsty, just like needing water. Make sure that water cup's away in the dishwasher or in the cabinet in the kitchen. Don't have like all that stuff out on the nightstand. Just make it look crisp and clean. Open the blinds. Make sure you have as much light as possible coming in. And I mean, this is really simple stuff to do. You don't have to go out to the store and buy a bunch of stuff. You don't even have to pay a professional stager. You can just work with what you got, and buyers can walk into your home and imagine themselves there and imagine their stuff there just by you having it clean. Have I ever mentioned I have a puppy? This is my dog, Zuri. She's really sweet. She's only like 5 pounds, maybe. She is a Maltese poodle, and I love her to pieces. Sometimes she gets a little stinky, right? The dogs, they just get stinky sometimes. It happens. And so with pets, so for showing, you can either take your dog with you, stick him in the dog kennel. I wouldn't have your pets running around. Like, I know cats are a little bit harder. So like cats is pretty normal to be out during showings because they like run a little bit more, I think, around the house and jump and stuff. But if you can get your pets away or keep them to a certain room during the showing, that would be great. Now, if your little furry lovers get a little stinky and your house smells like pets, and trust me, buyers smell it. Even if they are pet lovers, they can come into the house and smell your pets. You live there, I live in my house, and sometimes you just don't smell it. You can easily buy stuff to cover up that smell and like spray your home and, you know, just cover up that smell with a quick cleaning. And I think there's this thing on Amazon, like, I forget, it's some kind of spray, but that can help too. And if you spray it and have all of your air conditioning or heating, depending on the type of year, turn off, spray it, and then turn it back on, then maybe you can get that circulated through your vents so that your house is smelling really nice. And you don't have to make it like overwhelmingly smell like something else, but if you have that little pet smell, just covering that up for showings would be great. Another thing you could do is just buy a doormat, something simple, maybe Walmart, Target, a little decor out front, spruce it up a bit, or even a simple plant. Make sure all those cobwebs and everything like that is cleaned up around the front. Now you have some tips to get that house ready for listing and having buyers in your home. You don't have to pay a lot of money. You don't have to get a professional stager. My biggest thing is just clean up and hide stuff that you live with on a daily basis. It is super simple and it doesn't have to be overcomplicated. If there's anything that I can do for you, answer any questions that you have, or if you need some tips with home buying, home selling, feel free to give me a call, email me, contact me at this information up here. I would be more than happy to provide you with my free buyers and sellers guide. And also make sure that you hit the subscribe button so that you can stay tuned for all things real estate in Billings, Montana. Until next time, bye.